Part 3 of the playthrough. This is what happens when it tells you to go to Manhattan. You land here. And then they take away to shower a stretcher. Sorry about the yawning. But it is the back of 5, I think. In the morning, that is. Let's continue. Yeah, you've got to run all the way down here through screening. I've never actually looked over this way. I've always just ran straight to the JTF officer. But wow, that's pretty good detail, I have to say. That's the wrong one. I thought there was a restock there. Oh, so this will update your map. You don't actually have to wait there for the 100%. And it will load up these side missions where you get rewards to upgrade your security wing, which should be, it might not be up on the map yet, but the security wing is basically this building here, I think. It's a post office, it's your main base of operations. The quicker you get it up and running to 100%, the better. But where they are, let's go for a bounty. Oh,
there's a cold-blooded murderer out there. Some awful lady named Michelle Mason. I guess they want me to ask you to stop her, but you have to promise me you'll be careful. I'll upload her last known location. Nobody can say I didn't warn you.
Well, all these people trying to get in. You think they'd have some sort of way of keeping them warm, or quicker way? I know they're screening for a virus and stuff, but there's all these dead bodies here. That's gonna affect, you know, that's gonna cause a disease in itself. So I don't know why they just don't burn it. Plenty of space. Anyway. You can actually shoot rats. See, it's mental. Anything that pretty much moves, you can shoot. Another tip when you're starting, if you hear or see a civilian in need, always help them out. The experience points is always a bonus, and you get a nice little vanity item. And in most cases, it is actually a better vanity item than the one I was wearing. It's amazing how quickly those little helps all add up. Oh shit.